accept offers elsewhere, because I believe Jensen Bell is not an EPL star. I believe he's an elite league backup at the best.
I think he is. Certainly, we've seen players like Brandon Stones, Tom Murdy.
Nothing like optimism, is there?
No.
Anyway, Tom Pease nearly pays for that one and nearly makes me eat my words by feeding a puck in front, which Windridge will intercept. Here is Windridge. Tries to feed the puck across, doesn't manage to. It'll be intercepted by Udell. Now, Pollock takes the puck into the zone. Deeks around Davison, still going, Philip Pollock. Shoots top corner and that one hits the post. That was impressive play by Pollock then. He made Ben Davison look very ordinary indeed. A backhand one off the post with Favell beaten.
Unbelievable move by Philip Pollock. Makes everybody look like they're standing still and just denied by the post. It well and truly had Favell beaten that shot.
Indeed he'll be. Managed to confuse the pair of them. Face off to the right. And Callum Davies will take the face off for Billingham Stars. He'll lose it. Wins it at the second or third attempt by working the puck out from under his feet. Here is Nicklin. Cross-ice pass. Vinyarski score! And it's 1-0 to the Coventry ENL Blaze, thanks to Ricky Vinyarski driving one home off the feet from Josh Nicklin.
Well, we said they're the deadliest line on the team. We say it week in, week out. They are the go-to line if we want a goal. And once again, Ricky Vinyarski sends it soaring into the back of the net.
And he's got a big grin on his face, it's Ricky Vinyarski. Nice finish. 12-15 gone. And that was Adam Robinson who fired one home. Here is Pollock. Tries to work his way into the zone, eventually manages to. Billingham Stars deciding the best way to deal with the shifty hands of Philip Pollock is hit him. Pollock tries to tip that one and Favell gets across to block it.
Blaze need to get a little bit more urgency heading into the zone. I mean, Tom Pease, again, just took his too much time on that shot. He needs to send.
I think, work their way in and get tips, perhaps. Here is Kavaku who fires another one, it's free. And Williams digging away, still free. And that puck could have gone anywhere. Finn manages to dig it out and clear the puck to safety.
That is a painful moment. That is a painful moment when you're a centre, when you're down on the ice, the puck's a few inches away from you, you know there's nothing you can do with it.
And our Blaze need lead Billingham Stars 1-0. Owen tries to turn away. Dumps that one down the back of the net. Kieran perhaps will collect. Into the final 30 seconds now. Stevenson. Collected by Paps, fed out in front. Genuinely
on the centre work because that rebound could have been deadly.
Indeed it could. Here is Elder. He'll get passed back, Michael Elder, for the Billingham Stars, which is way around the back of the net. Still skating around the zone, gets a shot off. Adam Goss makes the save and it goes over to the corner here. Go over and collect. Tom Pease taking his time in getting over to that one.
Tom Pease really needs to get his head in the game. He's moving at such a slow pace at the moment. If either he's injured or he's just being slightly laxive.
Indeed, that's great play. Meanwhile, by Michael Elder, goes full length to keep the puck in the zone. And now James Moss will centre it. Shot. And it goes straight through Adam Goss from Simon Hahir. And it's one each.
Beautiful work there by the Stars. And I said the Blaze needed to convert the offensive pressure. Blaze defence, I mean, Ashton Genuine on the other side doing everything he could, but Tom Pease letting himself get sucked into goon tactics over the other side. Chase it in. It's a tactic that can backfire because you're giving the guy with the puck the space to skate with it, and when you've got players like Philip Pollock and Josh Nicklin who can skate with the puck and move, you know, they're going to punish you for it, but if you can cut off the pass at the pass, you'll defend well.
We haven't seen much of Paul Windridge so far this evening. He's on the puck now and tries to centre it. It's covered up by Adam Goss. The Billingham Stars top scorer, Paul Windridge, has been largely anonymous so far tonight. I've just put the kiss of death on that one, I think.
Yep, you probably have. Scorched ice for all of averages that no doubt, now that you've mentioned his name and said how quiet he is, he'll probably pick up his play.
Feed it across. It's taken off the stick of a Billingham Star in front. Seller shoots, it's free, kicked away now by Rhys Williams as we move towards the final 30 seconds. Elder tries to get a shot off, has his stick lifted at the crucial moment. Still trying to find his way through, Michael Elder feeds it away for Finn. Good save, it's still free, James Moss.
And that was digs good. Away. Aside from the shot, good active sticks work there by Tom Pease and Rhys Williams, making sure that the Stars player couldn't get the shot off or do anything with it.
There's a bit of a pushing and shoving going on there, but nothing really.
There you go, you left me all alone.
It is 1-1 after Ricky Binyarski scored for the ENL Blaze. Simon Hahir equalising for the Billingham Stars. Pattison now battles with Pollock. Pollock comes out on top on that one. He'll try and work his way behind the net, faced by two Billingham Stars. That's a horrific check then from Hahir.
And
he's put on his back then.
Jake Larkin's reaction there may now actually turn the power play into a 4-on-4.
See what happens here. He's going to get called. To his credit, Philip Pollock doesn't react. Chucked hard into the boards from behind by Hahir.
That, to be honest, though, as well, there should have been a hooking call in there as leading up to it. But a bit of a reckless check there from Simon Hahir. Both teams trying the, as I term it, the house play. As the puck goes loose in front of Favell, he didn't know where it was. Ashton Jenny now with it at the point, sent it in.
It's blocked. Elder will collect. The Billingham Stars can come the other way. Elder loses control of the puck. Nicklin has space. If he can get a shot off, he does. Nicklin, good save, Lavelle. Bit of shoving in front from Binyarski. He's still having a shove or two. He and Michael Stevenson getting involved.
What was that over?
I think it was just the usual protecting your goalie.
Yeah, usual. I do love the hypocrisy we hockey players have, that we don't like the opposition touching our goalie, but we'll do the exact same thing down the opposite end.
We'll see if what Billingham are concocting, if they'll have to win the face-off and get a shot off. They've got 8 seconds to do so.
But you know what? Considering this Blaze team is, as you've said so many times, 6 places behind this team in the league, to pull out this kind of a result tonight against the Billingham Stars, who have been nigh on unstoppable, the immovable object of the ENL this year, the Blaze team can hold their heads high.
They can indeed. It looks like the ENL Blaze are indeed, they are going to get a 1-1 draw against the Billingham Stars. Billingham remain unbeaten. But Blaze come away with a point.
Well, incredible advertisement for ENL hockey this was. It had everything. It had smooth skaters. It had hitting. It had grinding. It had amazing goaltending at both ends. I mean, Adam Goss, I don't really remember calling too many Adam Goss saves tonight, really, as opposed to Flavelle at the other end.
Not really, but the saves he had to make, he did make very well.
Definitely. As I keep saying week in, week out, Josh Nichols clone right there.